Hi, welcome you all for today's session. Today I'm going to talk about data pre-processing. Today in real world, we have large volume of the data is available, which is highly susceptible for noisy, incompleteness, and inconsistencies. And this is because of huge volume, and also we are going to take from the multiple heterogeneous data. So low quality data always produces low quality results. That's why we need to pre-process data before going to do the data mining. So today's topics are, I'm going to talk about the data pre-processing, what are the quality metrics and the major tasks in the data pre-processing overview I'm giving here. And one of the data pre-processing technique I'm going to discuss. So what are the quality metrics? Accuracy, completeness, consistency, timeliness, believability, and interpretability. These are the we need to check for the data quality. We need to take the correct data. We need to take the all the values must be filled. That is completeness of the data and consistency. To need to avoid the inconsistency and timely updated or not. Our database is frequently updated or not. And we have to see how trust the database is. And also we need to verify the interpretability, how easily the data can be understandable by the user. So these we need to take care for better quality. And there are four important data pre-processing technique. First one is data cleaning. The process of filling the missing values, avoiding the or eliminating the noisy data, and remove inconsistencies or the outliers is called as a data cleaning. This data integration, the process of combining the multiple heterogeneous data sources is nothing but data integration. The process of eliminating some of the dimensions or reducing the overall size of the data. There are many techniques are there, which is called as the data reduction. The process of scaling the data from large volume to the smaller volume. For that, again, we have different techniques are there, which is called as the data transformation. So the overall four techniques are represented in this diagram. So this is data cleaning. We need to clean the data. We need to integrate data from the multiple heterogeneous sources like databases, table, relational tables, are the flat files, are the data warehouses. A data transformation, bigger values to the lower values in scaling. And huge number of tuples are converting into the, or reducing into the less number of tuples or the tables or the dimensions. It's called as a data reduction. These are the four techniques. So let me start about the data data cleaning. Why do we go for the data cleaning? What is the need for the data cleaning? So just now I said the real world data is dirty data, noisy data, incomplete data. So let us see about the first one is incompleteness. So the data is always available, but most of the tuples does not have the values. Those are not filled with any values. Suppose for example, occupation, here the value is missed. So some of the tuples having occupation is missed. Then how to perform the data mining? Obviously this is considered as incompleteness. So the missing data may be, the reasons may be either equipment malfunctioning or inconsistency, or data may be entered due to misunderstanding or not registered history or the changes of the data. So many other reasons for incompleteness. Similarly, the data may be noisy data. So lot of data is available for data mining, which is noisy data, dirty data. That is nothing but noise is nothing but a random error or a variance for a measured variable. See this one, salary is minus 10. There is no meaning. This is the wrong entry, right? So usually this is either manually wrong entry or the system malfunctioning. So whatever causes, we are getting the noisy data. Inconsistency is nothing but some, suppose we are taking any banking example or taking data from the multiple branches. In one branch, they are using date convention as day, month, year, and some other branch, month, day, year, in some other branch, only consider the day. So like the date inconsistencies. So all the branches must be same. Then only because we are going to combine the multiple heterogeneous sources. So intentionally, some of the data may be for all the rows, we are using same thing. Suppose, for example, January 1st is giving as a birthday for usually by default, right? For any student. So similarly, intentionally, maybe sometimes the data may be inconsistent. So how to handle the missing data or incomplete? So to fill the missing, for the completeness of the data, we have to follow all these are the methods. So first one is to ignore the tuple. wherever the values are there are not there. So simply ignore that particular tuple. If we ignore all the tuples like this, obviously, suppose there are huge tuples are not having any values. If we ignore the tuples, obviously, our accuracy will be reduces. And another option is fill the values, missing values manually. If we fill the missing values for the tuples, for the attribute manually, it is a big task. Suppose out of 2000 records, 500 records having the missing values. Is it easy to fill manually? So that it is infeasible. Next, to fill the values automatically with global constant. So there are automatic tools are there. We are going to fill all the missing values. Wherever empty is there, I'm going to fill with the zero. If you use most of the data with the unknown data or the zero, so obviously it is not, we are not going to get the good quality results. Then attribute mean values. We can also fill the missing values with the mean values. That is average values. So sometimes even this one also not feasible. Suppose we are going to fill the salary values. So we are going to take the average salary of the all the tuples. 2000 tuples, what is the average salary? Wherever data is missed, those fields are filled with the mean value, average value. This is one solution for filling the values, missing values. Another one is, the more better one than this one is, the attribute mean for all samples belonging to the same class. So we are going to fill the average values, but by taking the similar classes only. So that is, suppose if we take the age group, we are going to divide it into three groups, youth and middle age and the senior citizen. Between 20 to 35, whatever salaries are there, we are going to fill the mean value of this one for where we missed the value for particular age value is 27. This average we are going to fill. Similarly, second class, third class. So this is another better than the second one. And another better one is the most probable value. We are going to predict the value by applying some probabilistic techniques such as Bayesian theorem or Bayesian formula or the decision tree method. So these are the methods for the to fill the missing values. Next one, how to handle the NICE data. If my data is having the random errors or the NICE data. So first sort the data and next they are divided into equal bins. So this is nothing but the partitioning the data. So first one is sorting the data. So given values are sorted. This is the price for in dollars, $4, $8, and these are the sorted values. After sorting is completed, then we have to distribute into the equally. So here I'm considering three bins, bin one having three values, first three, second bin three values, equally, usually equally. Maybe one value is extra, you can put in any one bin approximately. So like that, first divide the values into the equally. Then either use bin means or the bin boundaries for smoothing, for eliminating the noise. What is bin means? Simply in bin one, whatever the values are there, 4 and 8 and 5, we have to take the mean value. The mean value is 9. That is simply replace all the values with the mean value. Similarly in bin 2, replace all the values with the mean value. Bin 3 also replace. Now all these values you have to take instead of the original values. This is one method. Another method is bin boundaries. We are identifying lowest value and the highest boundary value, right? Lowest boundary value is 4, highest boundary is the 15. Now we have to adjust the value 8, which is either nearer to the lowest value or the highest value. 8 is very nearer to the 4. So that 8 is replaced with the lowest boundary, which is 4. Similarly, the second bin and the third one also we have to fill. So one of the method for handle the NICE data is the binning. Another one is the regression. So this is nothing but to smooth the fitting data. So avoid the NICE data by using the regression functions. One attribute is used to predict the other attribute. Under clustering methods, we are going to use the find the outliers by using the clustering techniques. Similar, we are going to group the similar kind of data into one group. Whatever objects or the data which does not comes under the cluster will be treated as a outlier and avoid that one. And combined the computer and human inspection. Detect the suspicious values are checked by personally human. So these are the methods for eliminating the NICE data. Data cleaning as a process. Actually, the data cleaning as a process is a big task. So actually, what about this data cleaning as a process? Here there are two steps are there. It is a two two-phase process. In first phase, we are going to identify the discrepancies. How to identify the discrepancies? What are the discrepancies? Discrepancies can be caused by several factors like poorly designed data entry forms, human errors in entry, data decay, or inconsistent use of codes, or errors in instrumentation devices, and many other causes. Whenever discrepancies occur, how to detect? These are the methods for detecting the discrepancies. Using the prior knowledge, we have to create the metadata and check the field overloading. Attribute values are properly available or not. We have to check the attribute values. You check uniqueness rule, consecutive rule, and the null values. So whether the attribute is correctly filled with the or not null values or the null values, all these things we have to check. And use commercial automated commercial tools. Automated tools are available such as data scrubbing and data editing tools, such as spell check, whatever we are using right now in mobile, automatically the word will be checked. So auto spell check. So such as data scrubbing tools can be used in pre-processing, and data editing tools like correlation and clustering methods. To do the clustering, we have data editing tools are there. This is the first phase. And then the second phase, data migration and integration tools are used. These also automated tools are available. Data migration tools allow transformations to be specified. And we have ETL tools, extract, transform, and loading tools. ETL tools are available for transforming from one form to another form. And we have integration tools. For example, Porter's Wheel is an integration tool, which is iterative in nature and interactive, more interactive. So that like this, we have to apply to avoid the noisy data. We have to avoid the incompleteness. We have to work just like data cleaning as a process. These are all the steps in the data cleaning, to clean the data, one of the data pre-processing steps. Thank you.